Holyhead, northwest Wales. The port, a vital connection between the UK, Ireland, and the rest of the world. A history of global maritime trade, including the raw materials to make aluminium. On the outskirts of town, it's D-Day. At the old aluminium smelting plant, two giant cranes must be brought down to earth, despite Tony Jackson putting the job off.
All we've done is push the cranes in the back, but it comes to a point where you can't push it any further. The back of the building is there, and you've got to deal with it. And today's the day we've got to deal with it. But anything at height is an issue, safety-wise.
It's a massive challenge to yank both cranes off their perch.
It's probably around 100 tonnes worth up there. As long as we bring it out at the same sort of steadiness and evenly, it shouldn't get twisted and it should just come flying at the building and break up on the floor. That's the theory. Hopefully it'll be a piece of cake, like a hot knife through butter, come flying at the building, collapse on the ground, would all look great.
Enter the cherry picker, carrying Smeagol and his hot torch to cut the running tracks.
The idea being that we cut it off just in front of the leg on this side, we do the same the other side, so that when it comes out, it falls donk, not donk donk.
Andy, leave about that much past the girder, yeah?
When it's on a rail and it's all greased up and lovely, it's very easy to move. Once one side's fallen off and it weighs, the first one weighs 50 tonne, and it's stuck like that, we've got issues. But shouldn't be a problem.
Cut it off, mate.
And with both tracks now the end of the line, the plan is to get gravity to help pull the cranes to the ground, if they run smoothly.
Well, now he's freed it up. Let me just see if it's free now.
Oh, here he is. Here he is. Well,
get on me.
Don't cock-eye it.
Sol Nyland wants to use a Scrap King's lasso and Diplodocus to pull the crane at the back forwards to knock the front one off its perch.
The hardest bit here now is just getting the cranes moving. Once you get the momentum in them, they'll just come on their own. It's all freed off, all the brakes are off. Should be good to go.
It's a tug of war.
Go on, pull it a bit.
Two 50-ton Goliath cranes versus Sol and Diplodocus. But the cranes have dug their heels in upon the tracks.
He's pulling that on the piss. That's more like a snap off before that pulls in place.
It's round one to the cranes.
So you're going to have to face it. You haven't got the pulling power of us.
Time to move on to plan B.
It's caused it to slightly skew if, and if you look on one side, there's a gap between the buffers, and you look on this side, the buffers are compressed, which clearly shows that the thing is on the piss.
They have to start again and throw two more machines at the problem.
Gently, 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 gently. Sol, do not do anything until we tell you.
Sol, in the high reach, will pull with the lasso. Two more excavators will push from the back.
Little pull towards you. Gently, 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 gently. Keep going to the end of the rail. Keep going to the end of the rail. Now, that's it now. Both cranes are moving. Yeah, keep going, keep going. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Come back, Chris, a bit, please. Go on, boys, go on, give a push. And she's stuck. This is turning into a bit more of a saga than we planned, but...
The mechanical combination isn't working. Time for plan C.
Go on, go on, go on, go on. Lovely. We're going to pull the first crane out with one machine pushing and one machine pulling. Hopefully, flop she goes.
Sol and his high reach are substituted. Paul Williams and his trusty 50-tonner come off the bench to see if they can change the game. This has got to work.
OK, everybody ready? Let's go! Let's go, go, go! Here we go. Look lively. Here we go, here we go. Just like that. Well, we thought it would happen. Now we give it a little push. Okay, and Willie on the other side. Can you give it a push, Willie? The bond snap, perfect. And she's wedged.
60 tons of Goliath crane is stuck in midair. Twisted on its tracks. In an act of defiance.
What a complete and utter today's been.
Coming up.
So you can see he's quite vicious.
Is there gold dust amongst the crumbs of shredded office plastic? And Tony goes back to basics.
Right, you smash him.